This video is sponsored by Skillshare because calf implants are expensive.
Welcome to 2019, everybody. Hashtag new year, new me, same upload schedule. So it's that magical time of year again. Everybody's watching YouTube fitness channels, Googling online, trying to buy fitness supplements, and in general, trying to lose weight, build muscle. It's New Year's resolution season. And I think I know just why that is, because guys, no matter what separates us as humanity, I truly believe that at their very core, all humans have a noble and undying spirit for self-improvement. To push beyond the physical limitations of our mortal bodies and strive for a long and prosperous life of strength, health, and mental fortitude. We want to get laid! That's right, guys. I think this is the first time I've ever done a video like this, but welcome to a Fitness for Women video. I mean, not for women. I mean, like, for women. You know, get. Yeah. No. Is that creepy? Okay, I'll stop. So there are three variables we're going to be analyzing for the purpose of this video, and I've included them right here on the right-hand side of the screen, as well as in the description box below with timestamps, just in case you guys want to skip ahead or jump around. Although, you know, you probably shouldn't do that because the YouTube algorithm loves watch time, so, you know. There we go. Much better. Relax, don't do it when you wanna go to it. Okay, variable number one, general amount of muscle mass. When it comes to physical attractiveness, what do women truly consider to be more attractive? What do you have to achieve physically, you know, fitness-wise, in order to maximize your opportunity, your chances of getting with the opposite sex? Are we talking Arnold Schwarzenegger, 230 pounds, 6'2", you know, champion, massive bodybuilder? Are we talking the Zac Efron, you know, 160, 170 pounds, good set of abs, but overall muscle mass that's, you know, it's nothing spectacular, it's nothing to write home about, to say the least. Or maybe it's neither of these, and the whole, you know, the generation of muscle is gone, that's, you know, leave that back in the 80s. Dad bod is the new thing, it's here to stay. Women don't want muscle, they want relatability, they want a little bit of a beer belly, they want a cuddly, happy... I really hope that this isn't the case, because if it is, what the fuck are we doing on this channel? Fortunately, there is a study that looked at this. This one is from UCLA. They took individuals, these are undergraduate men, and they essentially asked them to rate their physiques on a scale of 1 to 9, 1 being significantly below average muscle mass, 4 or 5 being somewhere in the middle, and 9 being like, holy crap, you're not just jacked, you're more jacked than pretty much everyone around you, you're essentially a bodybuilder. And they asked these individuals about their sexual history. Most importantly, how many sexual partners have you had? And simultaneously, what kind of sexual encounters were these? Are we talking, you know, kind of long-term relationships, or is it more so one-night stands and fling? So this is where it gets kind of interesting. When they surveyed these men, they found out that men with above average amounts of muscle mass were over twice as likely to have had at least 3 sexual partners in their life at that time, as opposed to men with below average amounts of muscle mass. The actual numbers was around 4 for the more jacked guys and 1.5 on average for the below average amounts of muscle individuals. And at the same time, these jack guys, or whatever you want to call them, were over twice as likely to have had more sexual encounters, which were flings or one-night stands, versus the men with below average amounts of muscle mass. So this is kind of a big deal, right? I mean, it's almost a, you know, open and shut case. I mean, more muscle, 1.5 versus 4, that's like, what, 3 times the sexual partners? Case closed, done deal. More weights, more dates, right? Well, not exactly. This study is nice and it's kind of interesting to look at, but it doesn't necessarily mean that specifically the factor which caused these individuals to have more sex was specifically and solely muscle mass, because there's so many other variables, external variables that you need to consider. A big one, which the researchers actually mentioned in the study, is overall testosterone. Maybe the fact that these men on average had higher levels of testosterone led to them simultaneously putting on more muscle mass, spending more time in the gym, and then this also led to other characteristics which women may find attractive in a male, such as higher levels of aggression, higher levels of confidence, higher levels of general success and ability to take risks, and, you know, even financial entrepreneurial success. There's so many other variables to consider which kind of go hand in hand with higher testosterone and thus more muscle mass. Wait a second, what was that? Can we rewind that? A little bit, even financial, yeah, there we go.
Thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. Skillshare is an online learning community for creators with more than 25,000 classes in the things that you want to get better at, whether it be for hobby or for work. Guys, it's interesting. I was actually talking to a friend of mine recently about how my home city of Toronto is exploding in population growth with almost 500,000 people immigrating to Canada in 2018 alone. This means that the competition for almost everything you do, it's gonna go up. So how do you get ahead of the curve? By gaining specific, tangible, and high in-demand skills which help you excel at whatever it is you do. You want to learn social media marketing or web development to get that kick-ass job you want? Skillshare's got a course for that. You want to learn to be a master of Microsoft Excel like me? Skillshare's got a course for that. Or maybe you just want to learn how to become better at something for fun. Like right now, I'm taking a course on Adobe After Effects so I can make better edits in my videos. And again, Skillshare's got a course for that. Skillshare is giving away a free 2-month unlimited access trial to the first 500 people who click the link in my video description box below, and after that, it's only around 10 bucks a month. It's a new year, so if you want to be one of those people who actually follow through with their New Year's resolutions by improving your skills repertoire and just becoming an overall better version of yourself, then Skillshare can definitely help with that.
So this study I mentioned, it's kind of cool, it's interesting to look at, but it's not necessarily the best because there are simply way too many external variables to look at. Plus, you know what? We need to stop talking to men. If we're trying to attract women, maybe we should actually ask women. I know. Shocking revelation! Another study was conducted. They took 114 undergraduate women and they gave them 6 different physique silhouettes of men. So essentially, they took all other external variables as much as they could out of the equation. They don't know how these men look in terms of their, you know, physical, facial attractiveness. They don't know how much these men earn. They don't know anything about these men besides the overall shape and silhouettes of their body. And they asked these women to rate on a scale and order these 6 silhouettes from least to most attractive. And the interesting thing is that they found the most jacked of the silhouettes, the bodybuilder, brawny looking guy, he didn't come first place. The number one most attractive physique, according to the women surveyed in this study, was actually 2 steps below that at the somewhat more athletic tone style body shape. Again, this is the 170-pound, 5'10", Zac Efron kind of guy, as opposed to the 200-plus-pound, competitive bodybuilder. The researchers actually described a sort of Goldilocks zone where it's not too much, not too little, just the perfect amount of muscle mass to attract women, at least the women in this study. This is interesting because when I was younger and I was on the bodybuilding.com forums, this predates Instagram, this even predates Facebook to a certain extent, back when the only source of fitness information was either literally reading it in magazines or scavenging and scouring on, bodybuilding.com forums or even 4chan, it's just things like that on these message boards. A lot of times guys would talk about how they're not actually interested in guys who put on crazy amounts of muscle mass and strength, essentially going for the whole bear mode physique. They used to say that the ideal for women, they chose a slightly cuter, slightly smaller mammal. They would call it otter mode. Otter mode meaning guys who, they look like they're fit, they have a good set of abs, a nice defined chest, arms that are more or less average, maybe a little bit higher. Again, Zac Efron, Ryan Reynolds, Ryan Gosling, stuff like that, as opposed to, The Rock, Dwayne Johnson, Arnold Schwarzenegger kind of physiques. And in this case, at least from this one study, that may be the case. But is that the case in all studies? Is there any other evidence against this? You're actually going to see one study I mentioned in a minute, which kind of goes directly against this. And it does get a little bit interesting. Okay, variable number 2. Which muscles are we specifically talking about? We have established that more muscle, generally speaking, is a good thing when it comes to attracting a woman. But, are all muscles made relative when it comes to the sexual attraction? I don't know what this is. There was a survey done by an online health website, and this one was pretty damn interesting. Not because of the actual results, but the magnitude and the sheer crazy disparity of the results. Let me explain. Participating women were asked, what is the number one most attractive physical feature on the male body? Now, this doesn't have to necessarily be pertaining to fitness or musculature. This could be anything from your arms and your abs or your smile, your eyes, your hair, anything at all physical on the male body. What is the number one thing that you find most attractive? And the results, like I said, they weren't that actually surprising. Chest was the number one answer, coming in at 24%. 24% of women women who answered this survey said that chest was the number one thing that they find most attractive anywhere on the male body. Arms came in at 19% and abs came in at 13%. So together, you know, all those guys out there who are doing just like all day upper body every day, they're not that wrong. It's not exactly such new and shocking information, but what was interesting was the disparity between the results. Because, for example, take legs. I mean, I've heard before, you know those guys who skip leg days? People will tell them, like, what are you doing, bro? Like, I mean, yeah, you know, chicks dig arms and chest and abs and all that stuff, but a lot of girls out there are still gonna appreciate a good, developed, you know, lean, healthy set of legs. And you think, okay, fine, maybe, you know, if arms are 19 and chest is 24%, maybe legs will be 10. No? Okay, what about 5%? You know, one in every 20 women has to be a fan of, you know, those athletic, strong leg. No? 1% of women surveyed, in this case at least, said that they find the legs to be the most attractive physical part of a man's body. So pretty much to all those guys out there who skip leg day, I'm not saying what you're doing is okay, but from a, you know, a women attractive standpoint, you could be doing worse. And by the way, if you guys are wondering about the remainder, 9% of female respondents said overall a V taper and pretty much wide shoulders, narrow waist. 3% said eyes, 2% said face, and 22%, the second most attractive overall physical feature on the male body, according to the women at least surveyed in this example, hair. So... variable number 3, strength. This one is kind of interesting, and as I mentioned a few minutes ago in this video, that there actually was one study which kind of contradicted what I mentioned earlier. I said that toned guys who have, you know, kind of like a fitness model look, actually were more attractive to women more so than a bodybuilder. This actually kind of contradicts that. Let me explain, because it's pretty damn interesting. They did a study where they took photos of men, and they pretty much like blocked out their faces so you can just see their bodies. They were wearing like tank tops, and they showed them to women, and they essentially said, can you please let us know how attractive do you find this to be? And also, question number 2, how strong would you estimate this individual is? And what they found, which is pretty cool, they found a linear relationship between these two variables. The stronger these women perceived these men to be, the more physically attracted they were to these men. And the cool thing is that, unlike in the previous study that I mentioned, where it was kind of like the bigger you are, the more muscular you are, the better we, you know, you think you're sexually attractive or whatnot, but eventually it's kind of like a bell curve. It's kind of going up, 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 and then you kind of reach this optimal level, this toned fitness model look, and then eventually the bigger you get when you cross over from fitness model into more so like legit bodybuilder, it kind of starts to dip down. Hence, you have this kind of bell curve pattern. Here, that was not the case. A linear relationship means that, like, pretty much keep going. You look stronger and stronger, and the women find you more and more attractive. And this is interesting because this completely contradicts what we talked about in the beginning. It's like, oh, is that a 5-plate deadlift? 315 bench press? Suddenly, you know, my heart's palpitating. No, it's not that. It's what the strength signifies. It's other variables which are somewhat, you know, believed to be correlated with that strength, such as increased levels of aggression, physical, emotional, whatever, increased health. Even on a biological evolutionary scale, an individual who appears, just visually appears to be stronger, there's a higher chance that he or she is probably healthier. And another variable, just to throw it into the mix of already 17 other ones and make it even more interesting and complicated, you have to ask, you know, when you're talking about these women, you're assessing, you know, how sexually attractive they find, you know, example individual A, are they talking about relationships or are they talking about one-night stands? Because researchers actually found that when it comes to assessing a man, whether or not he'd be a good long-term partner, you know, someone you may want to have kids with in the future, someone you actually want to build a life with, in many instances, the women actually prefer the guy with a good physique, but not a crazy physique from a muscle standpoint. Again, utter mode. But when these same women were asked the question of, okay, fine, we get that, but, you know, let's cut the bullshit. Which of these men would you find more attractive for a one-night stand or a fling style of relationship? Suddenly that kind of like maximal Goldilocks muscle zone, it starts to drift upwards a little bit. So it seems like when assessing what's more attractive to the average North American woman, it's relatively complicated because we've got multiple variables. And just to make things even worse, we've got multiple variables on the female side. What you do here, you know, you gotta maximize all these, but you gotta maximize them for the right woman, depending on what she's looking for. It's just a clusterfuck of things happening in different variables, and you gotta be the right man at the right place at the right time. Yeah, it seems like dating is a bit more complicated than, you know, it may appear on the surface. Who would have thought? So guys, to wrap up this video, we got three pieces of advice. Do you want a girlfriend? You should probably hit the gym. Do you want a one-night stand? Well, then you should definitely hit the gym. Or do you want to go for the all-time virginity world record? Well, in that case, get your fedora, start working on your anime body pillow collection, and for God's sakes, stay out of the gym. Here we go!